Why China? I hope you've seen this. If you've picked up any newspaper about China in the last three decades, you'll have seen these things all about China. They're all true. I would suggest they're not all necessarily relevant to you. And some of them are a little bit wrong. The one that's particularly wrong is combination of this 1.35 billion people and the wealthy middle class. If we could quickly go around table by table, what percentage of the Chinese population do you think are middle class? And what I mean by middle class is, as we would recognize as middle class, buying the same sort of things, enjoying the same sort of things, spending the same level of money. If you could just quickly go through table by table, what sort of percentage?
Under 10,
okay.
Under 1.
Under 1,
yeah.
Okay. 50%, okay. 10%. Ladies?
5%.
5%? The same? 35%, okay. If you ask banks, economists, they will tell you the middle class in China currently is around about 400 million people. So around about 30% or a third, roughly about that sort of number. What do they base that on? They base that on the World Bank definition of being middle class, which is a combined family income of $10,000. How many families in Britain or in Europe have a combined family income of less than $10,000 or around $10,000, and we would think them particularly middle class? Well, the answer is none. And not surprisingly in China, the answer is none too. This leads to some really weird things. There was just Credit Suisse came out with their annual report on the growth and the importance of the Chinese middle class, which was that every other bank and economist in the world then followed up on. They even produced in their report a chart showing the breakdown of ultra-wealthy, wealthy, middle class, lower class and poor in Chinese cities. And through all the blurb they were writing, when they put it into a picture, into a chart, their own chart was trying to say that in Chinese cities, there are no lower class and there are no poor. None. But they're still saying that this is an accurate reflection of Chinese society. Anyone who's been to China would actually see that this just is an impossibility. When we look at it ourselves, we look at the China-Britain Business Council, we look at issues of like how many people buy a decent family car and how many people make regular overseas travel. And we come up with a number around about 10%, about 120 to 140 million people. I know if I ask Chinese friends, they'll say it's about 5%. But why is this important? It's important because we need to recognize that there's 120 million people, still a lot of people, but they're spread up across a big geographic area. But if we don't recognize that it's more likely to be 120 million people, not 400 or 450 million people, or even something I heard last summer when even our own government representatives in China were telling a major British department store that it's within 5 years it's going to be 650 million people. If you're overestimating that the size of the market is three times greater than it actually is, you are going to put in the wrong level of resources into your business development. So we have to make sure that you're actually getting more accurate figures which are relevant to you. It also means on issues such as education challenges. I believe some people hear from further education. I hear it a lot now. From the universities I work with in the Midlands, about it's a bit of a struggle getting recruitment without realizing that for the last few years and will continue for the next 18 years, the number of 18-year-olds keeps on going down every year, little by little. So unsurprisingly, the struggle to find more and more 18-year-olds to attract as international students becomes that little bit more difficult. Fortunately, there's still quite a lot of them. So that's the good point. But the recognition is, it's not quite as simple as people think. As I say, all these things are true nationally in China. How appropriate are they in the region you're working in the industry you're working in, or in the type of company that you're talking to? Are they motivators or relevant to them? You're not too sure, and you have to try and find out. And the only way of finding out is asking questions.